I am the jaguar of the Inca king. We are hiding from the conquistadors in the secret city of Vilcabamba. We are sick with a fever. We need medicine that only you can bring. Follow me back in time through the blue mist, up the Amazon River to rescue my people.
Halt! I've been told to be on the lookout for a stranger. Who are you? I see your papers are in order. Two guides have been waiting for you. They have valuable information for you. They would like to talk to you about your journey up the river. When you are done talking with them, choose one to be your guide. To talk to Antonio, press this button. Press the button again to talk to Isabel.
Hello, my friend. They call me Antonio. Antonio Santos Rios.
I've been waiting for you. The jaguar told me you'd be coming. I've been guiding people along the river for almost 5 years. I speak Portuguese, Spanish, and several Indian languages. Isabel, the other guide, is my sister. We are at Vilaim, at the mouth of the Amazon.
We go west for many days. We'll be taking the canoe upriver. We'll need to use our paddles carefully to avoid the logs and whirlpools. Belen is a large port city. To the south, there are many ranches and mining operations. The river here is wide and deep and full of islands.
Why, today is September 4th, 1993.
I have picked out 3 tents, 400 pounds of food, 7 sets of clothing, 10 machetes, 13 harpoons, 80 first aid kits, and 20 candle lanterns. If you want to see the supplies, press this button. I have a map of the Amazon River Basin. If you want to look at the map, press this button. If you want to look in the guidebook for some information on something, press this button.
Malaria. Malaria is a serious infection that affects your blood and spleen. Malaria is caused by a microscopic organism that enters your blood through the bite of a certain type of mosquito, the anopheles. If you get malaria, you start feeling feverish. You have sudden outbursts of chills. You become anemic or weak because your blood is low on the red blood cells that carry oxygen. Your spleen becomes enlarged. You may even suffer brain damage. If left untreated, malaria can be fatal. You can usually, but not always, prevent malaria by taking anti-malaria pills before you travel to a place like the Amazon. Once you're there, you should stay out of mosquito-infested areas and wear insect repellent. You can treat malaria with quinine, which is made from the bark of the cinchona tree. Sometimes, however, malaria resists treatment and becomes chronic or long-lasting.
Hello, I am Isabel. Isabel Santos Rios. I've been expecting you. The jaguar told me you'd be coming soon. I've been exploring and researching the Amazon for several years for my degree. I speak Portuguese, Spanish, and several Indian languages.
We're at Belen, at the mouth of the Amazon.
We go west until we get to Peru. It's a long journey. You'll need to keep track of your supplies. We may need them to trade for food, shelter, clothing, or interesting items. When we run low on food, we can also go fishing. Belen is a big city. It is an old city. The Portuguese colonist founded it in the 1600s. To the north lies the large Marajó Island. Prehistoric Indians made beautiful pottery there 3,000 years ago. I have picked out 2 tents, 400 pounds of food, 10 sets of clothing, 10 machetes, 10 harpoons, 90 first aid kits, and 30 candle lanterns. If you want to see the supplies, press this button. I have a map of the Amazon. If you want to look at the map, press this button. If you want to look in the guidebook for some information on something, press this button.
Isabel is a good choice. Good luck on your journey.
My name is José. I am a cattle rancher. I am getting permits to expand my cattle ranch by 500 acres. I manage 10,000 acres of land and 7,600 head of cattle for a Brazilian meat packing company. Many people work for me, clearing land and caring for the cattle. You're at Belém. You go west. I'm not much of a river person, but I do know that the next big city you come to is Santarém. It's September 4, 1993. It's very difficult to clear the rainforest. If it didn't rain so much, we could clear it faster. We are clearing the rainforest and planting grass to feed the cattle.
The Inca people are sick with malaria. Cinchona is a medicine for it. Your quest is to find some cinchona and bring it to the Inca king.
What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add it to our photo album. What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add it to our photo album. What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add it to our photo album. What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add it to our photo album. What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add it to our photo album. What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add... What should we do with this? That's great! We'll... What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add... What should we do with this? That's great! What should we do with this? That's great! What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add it to our photo album.
The Inca King is pleased with your success. He would also like you to bring some cinchona. Remember, much of the forest is unknown.
What should we do with this? That's great! We'll add it to our photo album. What should we do with this? That's great! What should we do with this? That's great! What should we do with this? That's great. We'll add it. What should we do with this? That's great. We'll add it to our photo album. What should we do with this? That's great. We'll add.
The Inca King is pleased with remember. The real dangers are the fears we carry in our minds.
What should we do with this? We need to get moving along.
We have passed through a blue mist into another time and place.
We've reached the Xingu River.
My name is Claudio Villas Boas. I am leading an expedition to build airplane landing strips across southeastern Amazonia. I am also trying to make contact with the tribes along the Xingu River. I am trying to start a national park that will protect the tribal peoples along the Xingu River. If I can show the government that the Indians need protection, perhaps they'll establish one. You are at the mouth of the Xingu River. Stay off the Xingu and head west. Keep to the bank on your left till you reach Santarém. The air around the Xingu supports many tribes who know about medicinal plants, the Kayapo, the Shuruna, the Xipaya, the Munduruku, and the Bororo. Some mysterious tribes, like the Krina Krore, have for years killed all intruders on site. I'm sure it's sometime in June of 1946. The rainforest is thick and sheltering. It hides and protects many tribes. The forest has given them everything they need: food, housing, clothing, medicines, musical instruments. The rainforest is huge. There is room for everyone. Amazonia can hold cities and tribal villages too.
Maku Tribe. The Maku live in a territory between the Rio Negro and the Yapura River. They first encountered Europeans in the late 1800s and early 1900s, at the beginning of the rubber boom. There are two groups of Makus, the howling monkey Maku, who are isolated, and the tame Maku, who maintain contact with Brazilian and European settlements. The howling monkey Maku are thought to be the last of an ancient people that once lived in large areas of the Amazon basin. These Maku are excellent hunters and warriors who carry 6-foot blowguns and arrows dipped in curare. They also carry bows, war clubs, and stone axes. Mayoruna Tribe. The Mayoruna Indians live in western Amazonia near the Ucayali River. They are known as the cat people because they often have cat-like whiskers tattooed on their cheeks. The Mayoruna may have admitted some Spanish stragglers from Aguirre's voyage into their tribe. The Mayoruna were contacted by missionaries in 1654. An epidemic soon followed, and the tribe was reduced to about 1,000 people. After the missionaries left, the Mayoruna remained hidden and elusive. In 1851, W. L. Herndon sent the U.S. Congress a report that included these words: "The Mayoruna attack any person who goes into their territory." Munduruku Tribe. The Munduruku live along the Tapajos and Trombetas rivers. They are a fierce people who aggressively defend their territory. The Munduruku are known for their beautiful garments made of feathers and for their elaborate tattoos. Children begin to get tattoos at the age of 8, and their bodies are not fully decorated until age 20. The Munduruku are headhunters. They collect the heads of their enemies and their own warriors who die in battle. They put the heads on trophy sticks and decorate them with feathers and dyes. Witoto Tribe. The Witoto Indians live in the northwest section of the Amazon Basin in what is now northeast Peru and southern Colombia. Anthropologist Richard Evans Schultes spent time with the Witoto learning of their extensive knowledge of medicinal plants. They are also known for their large communal houses and hollow log signal drums. When Witoto warriors are successful in battle, they have a ceremony in which they eat parts of their enemies. They display their enemies' skulls as trophies, make flutes out of the long bones, and use the teeth in necklaces. The Witoto were first visited by Europeans in 1695. Until the end of the 19th century, the Witoto were left alone. Then they were enslaved during the rubber boom and forced to work far from their homes. Many were executed for trying to escape, and thousands of others died of disease and starvation. Yanomamo Tribe. The Yanomamo Indians live in large stretches of the triangle of Amazon rainforest between the Orinoco River in Venezuela and the Rios Negro and Branco in Brazil. They call themselves the Waika, the fierce ones. They live in small villages of about 60 people. Their land was relatively undisturbed until it was invaded by gold miners in the 1970s. The Yanomamo have a strong belief in witchcraft. They believe that all illness and disease comes from witchcraft or from contact with white people. The men engage in violent games in which they shout insults and hit each other over the head with clubs. As is true of all the rainforest tribes, most of the Yanomamo's wars are fought over women. A tribe's ability to acquire women through warfare is the quickest way to increase its population. And whether it's done intentionally or not, adding people from other tribes improves the genetic diversity of one's own tribe.